With barely a moment to put their failed T20 World Cup campaign behind them, the Aussies are already looking to their upcoming white ball series, which starts next week. The ODI squad was named today, and while Josh Inglis isn't on that list, the Western Australian is just happy to be back playing cricket after a freak injury.
His hand is healed now, but when Josh Inglis injured at the week the T20 World Cup began, he knew it was bad.
I just went straight away to worst case. I was like, oh, that's the World Cup done.
It happened in a freak golf accident, one he won't forget anytime soon.
Yeah, it was a weird sensation, like a huge vibration. And I just looked down and blood was like pouring out of my hand straight away, so I knew it wasn't good.
Watching the World Cup from the sidelines wasn't easy.
It was pretty hard, just not being able to be around the boys.
Hard for most Aussies to watch, even those coaching other sides.
The culture of Australian cricket has been challenged over the last 4 or 5 years. There has to be, you know, some improvements in departments, especially I think their fast bowling attack.
And what exactly the strategies were.
Not playing Mitchell Starc, our premium bowler, ahead of that game was a really significant moment as well.
11 of the 14 players in the ODI squad were part of Australia's failed T20 World Cup campaign. And as is the cricket turnstile, there won't be much rest. The first one-dayer is Thursday next week in Adelaide before the side heads here to Sydney.
It'll be Pat Cummins' first time as ODI skipper, with Travis Head returning to the side after Aaron Finch's retirement. In the test squad to face the West Indies later this month, Marcus Harris is back in favour and Scott Boland has been retained as an extra pace man. Chloe Amanda Bailey for 10 News First.